Today we will study about the properties of Poisson distribution. So the first property that we are going to study is about the mean of a Poisson distribution. Now I hope you all know the density function of a Poisson distribution. So what is the density function of a Poisson distribution? Yes, it is f of x is equal to lambda raised to x e raised to minus lambda divided by x factorial. And I hope you all know that lambda is the parameter of what? The Poisson distribution, right? So let's start with the mean of the Poisson distribution. Now, in order to find out the mean of the Poisson distribution, as usual, we take expectation of x, or we know that we can denote it by what? Mu 1 dash, right? Now, what is mu 1 dash or expectation of x? Summation x is equal to 0 to infinity x into lambda raised to x e raised to minus lambda divided by x factorial, right? Now this is equal to, I'm going to change my x factorial as x into lambda raised to x e raised to minus lambda divided by, how can I write my x factorial? X into x minus 1 factorial. This is also correct, right? So if I write like this, I can cancel these two terms. And again, when I check this one, this is a constant. I'm going to take this outside. E raised to minus lambda summation x is equal to 0 to, when I do this calculation, I should write it as x is equal to 1 to infinity. Then lambda raised to x divided by x minus 1 factorial, which is equal to e raised to minus lambda. And now I'm going to expand this term. So let's see what I get when I expand this term. When I put x is equal to 1, I get lambda divided by 0 factorial plus lambda square divided by 1 factorial plus lambda cube divided by 2 factorial plus etc. Right, which is equal to e raised to minus lambda. Now, here you can see that the lambda is common over here. So, I will take a lambda outside, multiplied by, now 0 factorial is what? 1 itself. So, 1 plus lambda square by 2 factorial plus etc. Now, do you remember this series? Do you remember? You have studied this in your maths class. What is it? Yes, this is nothing but e raised to lambda. Okay, which is equal to what? You know, e raised to minus lambda. I have an e raised to minus lambda over here and an e raised to lambda over here. So, what happens? Yeah, it cancels out and the remaining what I get is lambda. So, from this what can you infer? The mean of a Poisson distribution is its parameter itself, that is what? Lambda. Now let's see what the variance of Poisson distribution is. As you all know, what is variance in terms of central moments? Yes, it is mu 2 is equal to mu 2 dash minus mu 1 dash the whole square. Now here in this formula, you already know what is your mu 1 dash. What is it? Lambda. So this part is, you don't have to worry about the second term. All you have to know is about what? Mu 2 dash. Or you have to find what is mu 2 dash. Now mu 2 dash, again you know the formula, right? What is it? Which is equal to expectation of x square. Okay, now I'm going to rearrange this x square in another way. That is equal to expectation of x into x minus 1 plus x. Okay, now this thing is same as what? X square. Now, again I'm going to, by taking the additive property of expectation, I'm going to write this term as expectation of x into x minus 1 plus expectation of x. Now here you know what is expectation of x. What is expectation of x? It is lambda. Okay, so you just have to consider, or you just have to take this term into consideration, that is expectation of x into x minus 1, and just find out the answer for this particular term and substitute over here, you will get your mu 2 dash. After getting your mu 2 dash, what you have to do? You have to substitute this over here, then you will get your variance. So first let's find out what is expectation of x minus, x into x minus 1. What is it? Summation x is equal to 0 to infinity x into x minus 1 multiplied by what? Lambda raised to x, e raised to minus lambda divided by x factorial, right? Now here, again e raised to minus lambda is what? Your constant, you can take it outside. Then, I'm going to change this x factorial. So again, my summation, I'm going to change it as 2 infinity x into x minus 1 lambda raised to x divided by what? X into x minus 1 into x minus 2 factorial. Okay, now here these terms get cancelled. Finally, I will have e raised to minus lambda summation x is equal to 2 to infinity lambda raised to x divided by x minus 2 factorial. Now this is equal to, now I am going to expand this term. Okay, now let's see what I get when I expand. I get what? Lambda square divided by 0 factorial plus lambda cube divided by 1 factorial plus lambda raised to 4 divided by 2 factorial plus etc. Now here when you observe, you can see that here lambda square is a common term. So you can take your lambda square outside. Okay, so I'm going to take my lambda square outside. What I get is 1 plus lambda square divided by 2 factorial plus etc. Now what is this? E raised to minus lambda, lambda square, e raised to what? Lambda, which is equal to lambda square. So this term is equal to lambda square. Now what is that you have to do? You have to substitute this lambda square over here. Okay, now that we have got lambda square, that is for expectation of x into x minus 1, what I am going to do is I am going to substitute this lambda square over here. Okay, so you can see that I have substituted the value mu 2 dash is equal to what? Lambda square plus lambda. Okay, expectation of x, instead of expectation of x I have written as lambda. Then is that the answer? No. Okay, we have to arrive at what is mu 2. Now mu 2 is equal to mu 2 dash. Again I got my mu 2 dash as what? Lambda square plus lambda. So I am going to substitute that value over here. And what is mu 1 dash the whole square? It is lambda square. So that is also substituted. This and this term gets cancelled. Finally your answer is lambda. So what did you infer from this? The parameter of Poisson distribution is lambda. The mean of the Poisson distribution is lambda and the variance of the Poisson distribution is lambda. So in a Poisson distribution, the mean and variance both are the same. Now we will find the MGF of a Poisson distribution. So you know the formula for MGF, what is it? Expectation of e raised to tx. Now in this case, in case of Poisson distribution, we get summation x is equal to 0 to infinity expectation of e raised to tx into f of x. So what is it? Lambda raised to x, e raised to minus lambda divided by x factorial. Here again minus e raised to minus lambda is a constant, so I'm going to take that outside and then I'm going to club this and this term, that is e raised to tx and lambda raised to tx. So I get lambda into e raised to t the whole raised to x divided by x factorial. Okay, now I'm going to expand this term. So I get what will I get? Yeah, 1 plus lambda e raised to t plus lambda e raised to t divided by 2t divided by 2 factorial plus etc. So what is it? Which is equal to e raised to minus lambda e raised to lambda e raised to t. Okay, which is equal to lambda e raised to t minus lambda, which is equal to e raised to, I'm going to take the lambda outside, so I get e raised to lambda into e raised to t minus 1. So this is your MGF for Poisson distribution. Now let's first let's have a look at the statement of the additive property for a Poisson distribution. Now let x1, x2, etc, xk be k independent Poisson random variables with parameter lambda 1, lambda 2, lambda 3, etc, lambda k, Then their sum, okay, the sum of the k independent random variables, that is x1 plus x2 plus etc. xk, will also be a Poisson random variable. The sum of the all random variables will also be a Poisson random variable with parameters what lambda 1 plus lambda 2 plus etc. plus lambda k. Now let's have a look at the proof of the statement that is given here. Okay, now let's start with the MGF of the sum of the random variables. So, what is the MGF of the sum of the random variables? Yes, it is MT x1 plus x2 plus x3 plus etc. xk. Right, now according to the property of MGFs, and here it is said that x1, x2, etc. xk are independent, we can write this as MT x1 multiplied by MT x2 multiplied by MT x3 etc. MT xk. Okay, now what is MT x1? Yes, what is it? E raised to lambda 1 into e raised to t minus 1 multiplied by, what is MT x2? E raised to lambda 2 into e raised to t minus 1 multiplied by etc. e raised to lambda k into e raised to t minus 1, which is equal to, now I'm going to club all these terms, e raised to lambda 1 into e raised to t minus 1 plus lambda 2 e raised to t minus 1 plus etc. plus lambda k e raised to t minus 1, which is equal to e raised to, and here you can see that e raised to t minus 1 is a common term. So I'm going to take this common term outside and I get lambda 1 plus lambda 2 plus etc. plus what? Lambda k. So, what is this? This is nothing but the MGF of MT x1 x plus x2 plus x3 plus etc. xk with a parameter what? Lambda 1 plus lambda 2 plus lambda 3 plus etc. lambda k.